الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. We praise God and we bear witness that there is no God except the one God. Today is the first day of a new year. It is January 1st and I don't see a single person with a hangover in here. The first day of a new year, 1988, is also the first day of the rest of your life. And the Quran provides the ways and means of starting all over again. Anytime you want to. You can forget completely about the past and start as a totally new person, beginning a totally new life. The concept of repentance. Repentance, returning to God, being unaware for a while, and now deciding to return and be with God. I have put the theme of the new translation of Quran on the wall here for you, and I'm going to read it because I wanted to share it with you. Well, before I read it, I'd like to say that finally we've discovered the secret of happiness, the most elusive of all human searches. The secret of happiness is in this short theme here. Happiness is a quality of the soul, the real person, not the body. Therefore, a body that achieves all the material successes it longs for, money, fame, power, good looks, carnal satisfactions, often belongs to an unhappy person. The real person's happiness depends totally on the degree of growth, development, and fulfillment of the real person. This book, the Quran, maps the road to perfect happiness for both body and soul, both in this temporary world and in the eternal hereafter. So this is the secret of happiness. And you've seen the video that we made a couple of weeks ago, and they mentioned in it Eddie Murphy in his interview with Barbara Walters, and how he owns this big estate in New Jersey. He has his family, his mother, seeing him successful. He's got the success, the fame, the movies, the TV, millions of dollars, 5 cars, 2 Rolls Royces, a Porsche, a Mercedes, a Corvette. Yet he said that he was not happy. So what does a human being want in this world? Isn't this what everybody out there thinks they want? The millions of dollars, the Rolls Royces, the Mercedes, the estates, the palaces, and he's not happy. So this proves once again, this has been proven over and over, that material success does not bring happiness. If the soul is shrunk and not fed and not nourished, there is no happiness. This is the secret of happiness. Nobody can be happy unless the soul is nourished and develops and grows. Just try not to feed your body for one day and see how miserable your body is. Try for one day not to feed your body or give it water. The soul is exactly like that. If the soul is not nourished, but in our dimension here, we do not feel the pain. It is reflected in what Eddie Murphy told Barbara Walters, that he was not happy. It's reflected in that. This is the secret of happiness. A few weeks ago, they had the Barbara Hutton story on the TV, and many of you saw it. Same thing, wealth, fame, anything she wanted. Yet you saw her in the program trying to commit suicide. This is a true story, how miserable she was. The exact opposite of happiness. So what does everybody out there want? You want money, fame, good looks, success? But then, if the soul is not nourished, there is no happiness. The nourishment for the soul, God teaches us in the Quran, just like is mentioned in the theme here, that the Quran maps the road to perfect happiness And it starts the minute you wake up. We've been learning here from the Quran that when you wake up in the morning, the first thing you say is Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Right there, it's a good snack for the soul. It's a bit of nourishment. The minute you open your eyes in the morning, you say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, La ilaha illallah. There's no God except the one God. The Quran teaches us specifically, when you admire anything that belongs to you, you must say, MashaAllah. This is the Arabic, you can say it in English. This is what God gave me in English. Say, MashaAllah, you admire your car, your children, your spouse, your house, anything that belongs to you. And this invokes protection for your belongings, and it is nourishment for the soul. Because the soul is a piece of God. And when you say MashaAllah, your soul grows. Another bit of nourishment. You praise God. You say Alhamdulillah, thank God, or praise God. When something good happens, when you finish eating, when you start your car, you say Bismillah, and you, when you start eating, you say Bismillah, in the name of God. And when you finish, you say Alhamdulillah, thank God, praise God. When you see something wonderful, the sunrise or the sunset, or a flower, or a fruit, or anything God created, or a cute cat, you say, SubhanAllah. God be glorified. SubhanAllah, God be glorified. Anytime you think of God, because your soul is a piece of God, your soul will be nourished. Don't just eat the apple or the orange. Think, who made this? Where did it come from? Where did the apple come from? The perfect flavor, the perfect sugar, the perfect texture, the crunchiness. Who designed this? Where did it come from? It came from the air, by the way. And the liquid from the soil. That's where the apple came from. It starts as a little ovary. And then it grows. The leaves of the tree collect carbon dioxide from the air and link it together in chains. The sugar is carbon, C. Six carbons make one molecule of sugar. So the leaves of the tree, photosynthesis, you heard of photosynthesis, and the energy from the sun and the water from the soil, this is it, this makes the apple. And all the other chemicals. So don't just eat the apple to feed your body. Eat the apple and feed your soul by saying, SubhanAllah, God be glorified. Because the body you're going to throw away. The soul is you, and you're going to last forever. The best nourishment of all is the contact prayer, making contact with God. These are casual snacks. MashaAllah, Alhamdulillah, InshaAllah. You should never say, I'm going to do something the next hour or at 2 o'clock or tomorrow or next month or next week without saying, InshaAllah, God willing. You're going to shock your American friends first, but then they will get used to it and they will respect you later. And you will nourish your soul as you remind them and remind yourself. Say inshallah. So these are the snacks for the soul. And they may barely spare you misery, be it temporary or eternal, hell. It might. But the best nourishment is the 5 daily contact prayers. These are specifically prescribed by God at specific times, with specific utterances and specific movements. It's a numerical code, it's a combination that causes contact with God. Then your soul really grows. And like you heard on the tape the other day, the soul grows in leaps and bounds, which makes nourishment a lot more crucial and a lot more important than your meals for the body.